I am very jealous. That's the Grinch family right there. I wish I would have done that.
Sorry, they didn't have fat people size.
Okay. There you go. Ticket booth. Hey, Rory.
Hello.
You excited? Here are the tickets. Woo! Don't rip them. All right, give it back. Never mind. I got them.
We are in car E. So right now we're at L. So we got the whole alphabet to go. We gotta go all the way down. Okay, so we're almost there, finally. A lot of people here in their pajamas. This is the E train. Now we gotta wait.
Hey, are you all excited?
Yeah.
Awesome. Hey, are you excited?
Yeah.
Are you guys the cooks?
Awesome.
You guys the cooks?
Yep. Yeah, you want a high five?
What are you making for us?
Nice. Hot chocolate and cookies.
And cookies.
All right.
Me too.
Whoa.
That was a good one.
You did that a little hard there, Rory.
All right, guys. You can laugh it up all you want. This is what I'm wearing, all right?
Wait. There we go.
Yay.
There we go.
So the other guys for the cooks, what do you do?
I'm the main character for the movie. See? In fact, I even have...
a hole in the pocket! Oh,
that's why I keep my ticket.
There.
This one. There you go. I remember that on the train. Okay. To put anything in this pocket. Yeah, not this pocket. If you get any bells,
ladies and gentlemen,
put it in your good pocket, okay?
All ages, the Grand Canyon Railway.
That's a ramp thing, I think, for a wheelchair to be able to get up.
Someone's going to take your seat, and then you'll be able to go.
Yeah, you have to have a ticket to get on the train. Yeah. So.
This one doesn't have...
Here you go, Chef.
All right, it's good to go.
Thank you. I haven't been on a train since I went to New York last year.
I got you. I get that counts.
Hola.
Hey. Are you excited?
Okay.
Come on, over here. Phil Musk.
All right, guys. Wait, hello.
Thank you.
All right, Abby doesn't care.
Here we go.
We got these tickets back in September for this Polar Express thing, which is in Williams, Arizona, which is by the Grand Canyon, kind of, sort of, not really. It's like an hour away. So we're here on the train. It's an hour and a half ride. This thing costs $160 for the three of us, okay? And you know how frugal I am. So, you know, I'm only going to do this one time. So you better enjoy it one time. That's it.
Are you excited? Awesome.
I don't know what that guy is on, but I'm going to keep an eye on him.
Rory, what's Daddy going to do to Santa when he sees him? I'm not gonna do nothing.
Sit down. He's gonna. You are gonna punch him in the face.
What? There's no Wi-Fi on this train. No Wi-Fi.
Can you get over the Wi-Fi?
The mayor of Williams, if you're watching this, you need to get more Wi-Fi around this town, and you gotta upgrade your LTE because it's shoddy, man. We're finally moving.
Please refrain from leaning anything on it. And finally. If you'd like to have a
window open, please allow one of our chefs to help you. High five.
Here comes the conductor.
What did he do? He just put a bunch of holes in them.
He's pretending that there's hot chocolate in there. Okay, it's gonna drop.
Eddie looks very concerned.
Shiny.
I missed the lights. Oh, you got cookies. How is it? Cookies good?
I'll get a copyright strike if I post this song. Cartoon Life, are you enjoying your time on the Polar Express? Don't worry, I'll cover you up with cartoons. Don't worry. You guys enjoying your time?
Yes!
Pass the hot chocolate, girls. You like it, Addy?
It's a little bit hot.
It's a little bit hot, all right.
I got my hot chocolate right here. What's this say? Hot, 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 hot. That's what it says right there. It's not that hot. So they gave us the cookies, they gave us the hot chocolate. Only thing missing now is Santa Claus, and then the deal is done.
These guys get a good workout. Aurora just hand these to me because I'm like her garbage disposal. Rory, why do you always think I'm like your garbage can? You just always hand me stuff.
We're about to start the story of the Polar Express. If you have your own copy of the Polar Express book, you're welcome to follow along. Oh. The story is read aloud by the author, Chris Van Allsburg.
Oh, God. They're going to read the Polar Express book?
The story.
Oh, Maron, really?
On Christmas Eve, many years ago, I lay quietly in my bed. The elves cheered wildly.
Hey, flying zebras!
Flying zebras!
He marched over to us.
Nice.
All right, I got a confession.
The reindeer were
I've never
excited.
Seen the movie. I've never read the book. I have no idea what the Polar Express is about.
Santa handed the bell to me, and I put it in my bathroom pocket.
Before you get up there.
Where was Santa Claus? We're waiting and waiting and waiting. Where is this guy? Is Santa Claus Latino? Because he's late.
Stop taking this. He's not late.
He is late. It's the North Pole. Look at that. Ooh. It's Santa. There he is.
Wow.
There he is. The North Pole. I guess we're not stopping, guys.
Did you guys see Santa? Yeah, you saw him. You ready? You're gonna tell Santa what you want for Christmas, all right? You're gonna have to shout it. Rory, you know what you're gonna want? What do you want, Rory?
The biggest dollhouse.
The biggest dollhouse ever.
The biggest dollhouse that goes all the way up to my head.
Yeah, it's a big dollhouse, kid.
And then also.
And also.
I actually.
What do you mean, and also?
I actually just want a piano.
You also want what?
Piano.
A piano?
I'm actually a
guitar. Listen, you're your bird. You want the biggest dollhouse ever and a piano?
No.
Yeah, you're bird. You ready, Roy? You gotta say biggest dollhouse ever. Here he comes.
Looks like he got your letters. Mailbox is full.
All right, there's the elf. This guy's gonna find out where Santa is, because he wasn't over there. Where do you guys think Santa went?
Guys, guess what?
What?
Santa Claus is on the train! You guys hear that? Santa's on the train, guys!
Guys, you hear that, guys? Santa's on the train. He's coming to his rail car, guys! He's coming to his rail car! Alright, guys, now there is a few things we have to do. Now, Santa only comes to his rail car if we all sing. So I want to hear all of you singing the Christmas carols.
These guys want me to sing? They're out of their bird. I'm not going to sing nothing.
He knows if you've been bad or good.
Cartoon Wife, how much love is this?
Can you stop that? Hey, watch your mouth.
I always behave.
No, you don't.
Yeah,
never
I do.
Behave.
What do you mean?
Never.
I'm always well behaved.
No.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. What? What? Hey, Rory. Mommy says daddy's always a bad boy. Is that true?
Yeah.
What? What?
All right, guys, next up is about everyone's favorite snowman, Frosty the Snowman.
All right, we're gonna hear it in a minute. All right, calm down. So listen.
You gotta sing it loud.
It's easy, I'll sing it for
you. You know, me and your uncle, Rory, you know, me and your uncle Alex, one day we waited up for Santa Claus with a bat.
You've told this story 100 times.
Guys, next up is the 12 Days of Christmas. We like to have a little competition with this one. So on five golden rings, all the guys stand up and go, five golden rings!
Yeah, you gotta stand up and do it.
I'm not gonna be standing up doing five golden rings. I'll tell you that right now.
Five golden rings! Four calling birds, three
don't do drugs, kids. Seriously, don't do drugs.
Well, drummers drumming, lead pipers piping, tambourines a leaping, nine ladies dancing, eight maids a milking, seven swans a swimming, six geese a laying, five golden rings, four calling birds, three French hens, two turtle doves, and a partridge in a pear tree.
Monsters you think this guy drank?
At least five.
Red Bulls or Monsters?
Monsters.
Yeah.
I need one.
I'm gonna ask him at the end. I'm definitely gonna ask him.
Do not.
This guy keeps looking behind him for something. I bet it's Santa. Bell. I got a question for you.
What's up?
How many Red Bulls did you have?
Zero.
How about Monsters?
Zero.
Really?
I don't drink those at all. It's just, you know, I'm 18, so I'm hyper.
Okay, cool.
Thank you. So you guys want a ticket sign? Have them out, please.
Cartoon Wife is mad. Oh, we're back in town. It's all lit up. We're back for the North Pole, guys. So that's it, we're coming up to the station, the ride's over. We got the cookie, the hot chocolate, we saw Santa Claus, we sang some tunes, they gave us these bells. The show's over, guys. So this concludes another edition of Arizona Living. Be sure to like, subscribe, and let us know below. Have you ever met Santa Claus on this train thing? Till next time.